Dear viewers of the Tom Photo channel, this video belongs to my series on creating tools for photo analysis. Other videos with related tools are listed in the description box down below. Today's tool allows you to find out the dynamic range of your photo and more. It reports several useful parameters in tabular form. The tool automatically finds the following parameters for all photos in the current folder. I trust the first four parameters are quite self-evident. Dynamic range is calculated using three different methods, and the signal-to-noise ratio is also implemented and reported. You can pause the video here to read more about these methods if you wish. It's up to you which dynamic range method to use. They correlate well with each other, so any one of them is good. All results are reported automatically, and you may want to average the results by all three methods for a grand average. This solution works well whether you have Linux, Mac, or Windows. I should mention that there are advanced algorithms for calculating dynamic range and signal-to-noise ratio that cannot be implemented based on single images. My implementations are simple and work for single images. Now, how does the tool work? It is straightforward and requires minimal effort. The tool is in the form of a Python script, which you can download using the link in the description box. Once downloaded, place it in the same folder as your photos. Use the terminal to navigate to that folder and type python3dynamicrange.py. Many of you can now stop watching this video and simply start using the script. Well, perhaps consider subscribing to my channel before you go. For those less familiar with running Python scripts, please stay with me as I will now explain how to run this script in a simple way. Download the dynamicrange.py file via the link below and place it in the same folder as your photos. When you run this file, it will create a table with many parameters for each photo. Ensure you have Python installed on your computer. If not, follow the instructions provided for Linux, Mac, and Windows. Now that you have the dynamicrange.py file in the same folder as your photos, run the script via the terminal and view the results. Open the terminal, navigate to the folder where your files are, type python3dynamicrange.py, and press enter. For those unfamiliar with opening the terminal and navigating to the folder, just look at the description box. I think it will be quite obvious. Let me run an example for you, assuming you don't watch the more detailed tutorial in the links. I'm using Linux, but the logic is the same for all operating systems. My photos and the dynamicrange.py are in a desktop folder called MyPix. I open the terminal and navigate to my folder by typing this. The process is very similar for Mac, while in Windows, the line would look something like this. Next, I run the script by typing python3dynamicrange.py and hit enter. The script may not be very fast, so bear with it. Reviewing the script's results, you'll find a new file named drandmore.txt in your folder. This file contains all the numerical results. Each photo corresponds to a row, and the parameters are in columns. The file is tab delimited, and a good way to view this file is using Microsoft Excel or LibreOffice Calc, for example. If you encounter issues running my script, please check the links in the description where I address these matters. For additional questions, leave a comment and I'll help you. You can also request more scripts like this, and if there's enough interest, I might develop these solutions for you. Interest is measured based on the number of likes and the number of views. I'm soon producing a video where I compare two Nikon cameras by analyzing their photos with this tool, so stay tuned for that. Thank you for watching. If you feel like subscribing to my channel and leaving a like, please do so. It will help me. Goodbye.